Hello, hello, hello. How are you? I trust that you have been well. I'm also fine, and I thank God for this far. Thank you so much for joining me once again on Nasaha with Naomi. I don't take your support for granted. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. Thank you for sharing the links. I know some people have been sharing the links. So I'm so, so grateful for you and for your support. If you're new here, karibu sana, sana, sana. We like visitors on this channel. Kindly join the family by subscribing to this channel. So you subscribe by hitting the red button just below your screen. So karibu sana, sana, sana. Follow me on Instagram. I'm Nasimiu Boaz. Follow me on Facebook. Naomi Nasimiu, let us get the conversation going. So thank you so much. Today I want to talk about something very important, something very sensitive. And today I'm talking to men. So men in the house, you can say hoye, because today whatever I have is for you. A few weeks back, I talked to the women, I talked to the ladies, and if you check on my videos, probably I'll leave the link on the description box. There was a video that I did titled, Does He Still Love Me? So that was for ladies, but men can also check it out. You can learn one or two things from there. So today I'm talking to men, and men, today I want us to talk about the red flags that you should watch out for, signs that you should watch out for that could tell you that probably this woman you're having in your life could be wasting your time. You know, she's not there for keeps. She's just there for a while and then she goes. So I want us to look at 15. There are 15. Probably there are more than that, but today I have 15. 15 signs that show you it will not work. 15 signs that show you it will not work. So before we continue, just something that I should say. Your girlfriend or your fiance could be having some, maybe one or two of the signs that you're going to look at. Maybe it is not a reason for you to leave. It could be something that you can work out, you know, talk about, work out so that she improves. But if you find that she has a majority of whatever we are going to talk about today, then it could be a reason for you to reconsider the relationship. So thank you so much for joining me. Now, straight up to sign number one. Sign number one. It is always about her. It is always about her. And it is true that women love attention. But this one, you know, her craving for attention is too much. Too much. So even if you are just promoted, you know, sometimes things happen in life and you just want someone to listen to you, someone to be there for you, just to give you an ear, you know, just to give you a shoulder, to give you that hug, to give you assurance. But you find every time something important, something major, and sometimes it is even the minor things, you know, just something that is disturbing you and you're trying to talk to her. But every time you bring out a discussion and you want to talk about your family, you know, your fears, your discouragements, every time the topic just changes and it becomes about her, what she wants, what she feels, her pains, her struggles. And there is never, never, never a time that it is about you. Then this is a sign that she could be wasting your time. And a hint for you, once you tell her that you want a break or you're walking out of the relationship, if she cares, she will come and ask you what the problem is. You know, she will come and she'll try to reach out. But if she doesn't, then it was never meant to be. Sign number two, you have different values. Different values on religion. You're a Christian, a born-again Christian. This one is of a different religion. The Bible says in the book of Amos that can two people walk together unless they are agreed? So if you don't agree on religion right now, even after, you'll never agree. So you have different values on religion, different values on finances, how you should spend your money, how you should save your finances, but your partner has different ideas, different values. Then this is a major thing that you should not overlook. It could be a sign that it was never meant to be. She has different values on family. You know, once you get married, they're like, or even you're dating and you keep on hearing her talking about open marriage. And an open marriage is a marriage where you're married, but you've talked to your partner and you've agreed that you can have relationships with, you know, people of the opposite sex, even when we are married. Others, you know, they don't want to have children because nowadays there are people who get married and they don't want kids. So you find you want children, your partner is not for it. She says she wants to be married and that is the end of it. So if you differ on such values, then walk out. Walk out as early as possible. Live in peace. Go and find someone that you're compatible with. Another sign, number three, she is too busy. Too busy for you. Never there. You know, she doesn't create time for you. No time for you to sit down together. Even when will you plan about your future? You know, when will you talk about your struggles, the challenges that you're facing in your relationship? So you find that most of the time, she is too busy for you. If a woman loves you, she will create, no matter how busy she is, out of her busy schedule, she will create time for you. So if she is too busy, then it could be a bad sign that you need to walk out. Number four, she mentions her exes and other boyfriends. She mentions her exes. So every time, and she mentions in a way of comparing you to them, not in a way of maybe job or something, and it is not once in a while. So every time you're talking, every time an issue arises, the name of her ex must come up. Or every time she's comparing you to the way so-and-so dresses, you know, a certain guy in church, a certain guy. You know, I even heard of another girl who was talking to her boyfriend, and she was telling her boyfriend, I like so and so. And you know, she's talking about another man. I like so and so. He's so, you know, he's so ambitious. He's so outgoing. And you're talking to a man who is an introvert. So how do you expect this man to feel? So if you're always being compared to other men, this is a bad sign. In fact, a very bad one. Because for one, you could be a rebound. She's not over her ex. So she keeps on, the name still keeps on coming. She's not healed from her past relationship. So the name of the ex keeps on coming up because you'll find it is not all the exes. Probably it will be just one ex. This is a sign that she's not over him. So you're just a rebound. So this is a bad sign and it shows that you should walk out. Another sign, another bad sign is that initiating contact is one-sided. So you are always the one coming up. You know, when are we going to meet? You are always the one calling. You are always the one texting. She never makes the effort to call you first or to text you first. And at times, even when you communicate to them, they don't give you feedback. You're asking them via text or an email, and you find that they're not responding. So this is a bad sign. It shows that this girl is not into you. Because as we all know, girls love every now and then you call them. So you pick, you talk, and once in a while, if they see you have not called, then they will call you. But if you're always the one doing it, then it is a bad sign. Another one, another bad sign is that the relationship is hot and cold. Hot and cold. Some kotu hapo, katikati. Sometimes it is hot. It seems as if you're so much in love. At other times, it is very cold. And end up missing in action. So she's never there 100%. And every time you go on cold mode, it is your fault. Hakuna siku yenye yako na makosa. There is no day that you will be cold because of her. So every day it is you. You are the one who didn't call. You are the one who is messing us up. You're the one, and you know the way ladies talk, and they can be very, very nagging. So if it is always your fault, why you are separating. This week we are together. After 2 weeks, we have separated. After 2 months, we are together. And it is always your fault. Then this is a very, very bad bad sign. It shows that something is wrong somewhere. Another bad sign is that she has changed since you started dating. She has changed for the worse, not the way she used to be. If she used to call you, she no longer cares. She doesn't call you. And let me tell you something. If you call your woman frequently and then something happens, maybe you're angry or something, and then you don't call her, I'm telling you, she will not have peace. She will keep on calling and nagging, wanting to know what the problem is. But if you used to call and then one day you say, let me see what she will do, I'm not calling, and then she's just quiet day one, quiet day two, quiet day three, something is wrong somewhere. So if she has changed, you know, she used to tell you she misses you, she loves you, but now the conversations are changing. So some naenda ile cold mode, then it is a sign that something is wrong. If she is needy emotionally, this is another bad sign. You are not a therapist. You are not a counselor. You want to be in a healthy relationship. If you get into a relationship with a needy person, then you will not go far. If this person is nursing past wounds, past trauma, she was abused, you know, she has just been, you know, she has just been ditched out of a relationship, and you are there for, you can be there as a friend, you know, just as a friend, someone she can talk to, but don't go to the next level first until she is properly healed, because your relationship will always, always be having issues. So if she is wounded emotionally, she's traumatized, what she needs is therapy, a counselor. And you're not one. Just be there as a friend. Once she is healed, you give her time. Once she's well emotionally, then you can go to the next level. Another one. This one I'll not even say a lot. If she has been unfaithful, then it is a sign you should walk out. Don't tolerate someone who is unfaithful. Someone who is cheating on you with other people. You think you're in a relationship, she's playing you. She's walking with everyone, you know, and getting, you know, being taken to coffees and chicken and dinner by every man around. Don't accept that. So if she's unfaithful, walk out. Another one, she doesn't have your back. When she's with her friends, with her family, she doesn't defend you at all. You know, always exposing you. That, you know, this moment you're expecting her to stand up for you, she leaves you there hanging. This is a very bad sign. Any woman who loves you should have your back, should support you, even when you are wrong. Then when you're behind the scenes, just the two of you, she will correct you and tell you, you know, bring up the conversation and tell you, I didn't like this and this and this. I disagreed with this and this and this. But if she does it in the open, when everyone is there, even when you're married, she will go and she'll take all your problems to her family members and her friends. You will be an open book to everyone without you knowing. You will never be respected in the society. So if she doesn't have your back, a very big red flag. Another one, number 11, she has no girlfriends. Now, this one might seem a little funny or even weird, but it is the truth. Because her ability to make great friendships and to make great relationships shows you how loyal and how great she will be in your relationship. If she doesn't have girlfriends, at least she has, her friends are only men, or she's a loner, she doesn't like socializing with other people and interacting with other people, then it is a red flag that she will not make a great partner in your relationship. Number 12, she is a gold digger. She's after your money, after your resources, you know, after your wealth. And it could not only be, you know, in terms of money and wealth, it could be she's using you as a stepping stone. There is something she wants, and she knows the only way she can get it is if she pretends to be in love with you, to be in a relationship with you. Then after she gets whatever she wants, could be a promotion, could be a job, could be a contract, after she gets whatever she wants, she walks out. So you will just, if someone uses you, you will just know it. It is just that most of the times we want to overlook the signs. We want to overlook the signals. But if she is using you and you are allowing yourself to be used, then let you be used, and then you will be dumped. No sooner has she gotten whatever she wants than she will dump you. So if she's a gold digger, walk. Kanyaga kubwa kubwa. Number 13, she wants you to be the perfect couple. In this era of social media, wants great pictures. You know, a picture perfect couple. She wants to sell the idea that you are great. You know, you never disagree. You always agree on everything. You have, you know, you are well off, you are wealthy. And it is a lie. If this goes on in the relationship, it will be worse in marriage. So it is, I'm not saying that you go and show your flaws and you are, you know, you wash your clothes in public, you know, so that everyone knows your weaknesses and your strengths. But what I'm saying is that it should not be like an obsession. It is not, it should not be like an addiction that you have to show that you are picture perfect, that you are great together. So it is a very big red flag. Because this is a person who will keep on, once you get married, she will keep on comparing your marriage and comparing you to other people, comparing your marriage to other marriages, comparing your milestones in family to other people's milestones. So and so is having a baby, so we should also have a baby. So if she wants you to be the perfect couple now, in marriage it will be worse. It is a sign that it will not work out. Number 14, she never apologizes. It is, you know, she never takes responsibility of her actions. If someone is wrong, that person should apologize. You know, and this is very common in most women, that even when you are wrong, we are trying to twist issues so that it ends up being seen that it is as if this man was on the wrong. So if you are wrong, just be honest with yourself and be honest to other people. Apologize if you are on the wrong. So if she never apologizes, never takes responsibility for her actions, then don't go along with it. This is an irresponsible person. Number 15, the last one. You are always walking on eggshells. Always walking on eggshells. Every time you fear that if you say something, if you do something, sometimes it goes to an extent of even dressing in a certain way. You are going to trigger something. You know, she's going to snap. She's going to lose it, to lose control. So every time you're very careful, the people you're very careful with the people you associate with. Very careful, you know, with the way you talk to her. It even reaches to an extent you have to change who you are because you want to please this woman. If she can't allow you to be yourself, then it was never meant to be, because you're supposed to be real. You're supposed to be you in your relationship. So if you fear doing things in a certain way because you're going to offend her, you know, she's going to erupt like a volcano, then it is a sign that it was never meant to be. So these are the 15 signs. I know most probably there could be others, but these are the ones that I have for today. 15 signs that this relationship could not work out. So thank you so much for joining me. I know you will enjoy this video. Kindly give a like, leave your comment in the comment section below. Let the conversation continue even in the comment section. So I thank you so much for joining me today, and until next time, I love you so much. God bless you and bye bye.